a kind of epigenetics that interests psychologists involves modifying DNA without changing the sequence. Molecular tags, known as methyl groups, get attached to the DNA, and once tagged, this can signal for a gene to be turned off or silenced, regardless of the actual sequence.
So this is an example in mice that was done a while back, and it demonstrates the power of the environment on your genes. Two genetically identical strains of mice from different mothers turned out looking very different because their respective mothers had very different diets. Now, one pregnant mother was fed a diet rich in nutrients for things like methyl groups. The other mother was fed a diet lacking nutrients for these methyl groups. The mother who had a diet rich in nutrients for methyl groups gave rise to offspring that were obese and had yellow fur, whereas the mother that had a diet lacking these nutrients had normal offspring that were non-obese with brown fur. Now, the amazing thing about both of these mice is that they're genetically identical. The mother who was fed one diet rich in nutrients presumably was able to regulate gene expression in a certain way that gave obese mice with yellow fur. The other mother was fed a different diet, which alternatively affected gene expression and resulted in a brown-furred non-obese mouse. So importantly, these two mice are genetically identical, but they turned out, appearance-wise, very different. We refer to these as having the same genotype, but a slightly different epigenome and a very different appearance, or phenotype.
So although this is yet to be shown in humans, it demonstrates that genes are not our destiny. Their expression is influenced by what we do and get exposed to from our environment. So let's go to this quiz.